Hey YouTube, John Rockin' TV One here, and I just got in from the All Outdoors, and over the last couple of days, some guys have been leaving comments on my 100 pounds of coal in this U.S. Army cannon heater stove, and asking me how do you light it, and well, I think I wrote on the comment, you know, you can light it with wood, and well, how do you adjust the draft and all. Well, that stove there has two air inlets. That one down there on the bottom with the shaker grate. Yeah, let me, a little bit slower on the zoom there. And that right there is the secondary air, or the over the fire air. And that is the primary air. And that's where the ashes end up at. Yeah, and you shake that little thing. Cause this stove is old. And there's no replacing the castings unless I form them up and have them cast. So I do my best to not break them, which means that I use a technique, what's called slicing. So I use a very thin poker, and I go down through and open it up so that it burns, and I don't have to beat my shaker grate all the hell, because she is old, you know, obviously. I'm going to show you how I light this. Now, let's just say that you don't have any wood, and all you have is that pile of coal over there. Which happens to be, that is chestnut-sized coal. And I could probably be using stove coal, but we don't have any here in New Hampshire. And you also got to remember that coal is a lot more expensive now than it was in 1900 or 1890 when this stove was made. This stove, however, is the most besterous wood stove that you could have. That thing burns them green, wet, loaded with snow. It doesn't really matter, because you got that bottom air, and it's like burning it outside in the campfire. And I can tool that thing right up to 800 degrees, make a 400 degree flue temp, and just, you know, it will definitely eat the wood up, but you will not be cold. Let's just say that. The deal of this is, though, is that with coal being, $7 for 50 pounds or more, you don't want to burn it up like that. You want to just make it so that it stays running in your house or in your basement, and over time you just keeping the building warm that way. You never let it get real cold if you can stand it. Of course, when I burn wood, that's not an issue, but the coal, of course, you don't want to just burn it up. And like I'm saying, being how this stove is old, it was built to burn coal, it was built to burn wood, and it is large so that it could heat maybe a tent in the army. So already we're getting a little on the long side, but I guess I'm making this so that the coal burning noobs there can have a little bit of tips. So let's say you don't have any wood to start with. Now, you could make a wood fire in there and then slowly add your coal on so it doesn't, you know, damp it out. But what I'm going to show you here is a completely cold stove, completely cold. And we're going to show you in here how I light this and make it easy peasy. Yeah. Got my long johns on. Here's my stove. This is your average everyday Harbor Freight weed burner. And we turn the gas on. And the deal of burning coal is that it wants to breathe from the bottom, which is why you have primary air on the bottom. It sucks the air up through, and the coal burns that way, unlike a wood fire that wants its air over the top. If you give it all that under air with a wood fire, and you can, you won't have any coals left in the stove at all. There would be no coals at all. So in order to get coals with a wood fire, with a stove like this, you need to burn it down, shut the primary air off, and just let it have enough secondary air that it lasts as long as you need it to. So I do this, for starters, just to get me a little draft going on. Just sit that in there, watch a little TV, hang out for a minute. Okay, let's imagine that I already did that. You'll know when your flue pipe gets warm because, you know, you got a temp gauge on there. Whoops, with the focus. So, I don't know if we're going to see down in here now. Yeah, here's another little gig. Let me turn that fire up so we can see in here. Okay, so, I'm seeing in there. Yeah, are we? There we go. There we go. Okay, so some guys talk about putting fire brick and lining their stoves with fire. This thing is like half inch thick. cast iron. And if you grind it with fracturing material, you're not, unless you burn a grain wood, you don't need that. The whole point is the cold book burn, heat the cast iron heats your room. And so if you do that, screwing the pooch game again. You can see that I got what's left of the ashes because I just shoveled this out. However, that bottom ring is it's a solid bottom ring with the shaker there in the middle. And so right now with this flank going on here, that's my damper, my stove pipe damper is open. And that heat is going up the pipe, getting me a little bit of draw. And so now what we're going to do is just take this here burner, and I'm going to show you. Let me back out of here. Okay, so I got a little fire going on in there, and you can see it. And then I go like this. Just like that. Now a little more fire. Okay, so now you can see in there I got that coal. Hopefully you can see that. Covering my grain, okay, and the ashes are around sealing the big ring because I'm not trying to burn 300 pounds of this in 15 minutes to warm up my army tent, on the side of Valley Forge, even though I am up here in New Hampshire. But now what we're going to do, okay, so now what we're going to do is chuck that down. Now I'm expediting the video for you guys. Then I take this and open my underneath here and stick this in here. Now it doesn't have to be on, you know, blow up your hot air balloon, turbo burner. But you can already hear that stuff crackling. And all that, I don't really want a big fire in there like that because it's old cast iron and you don't want to temp shock it. So I take that and I take my little hook that I use to do this with. And I just hook me up a little dead man like that so that it just hangs there. And then I go hang out for, 15 minutes. And before you know it, there's a fire going on in there. And so we're already at 10 minutes of video there. And I'm going to tell you that you're going to have to trust me. I'm going to bring you back in 10 minutes and show you the inside of that stove. Okay, I decided that maybe for some of the doubters, the doubting Thomases in the room, that I might just show you here. Okay, so you shut the door and you leave your damper open, all the way open, and of course I'm speeding this up for you guys, but in 20 minutes from to where I started, you should have a fire if you're not talking into the camera. But let's look down in here, just so you know that I'm not making the giant hot air balloon burner. You know what I'm saying? All I want to do is just let that fire creep up in there. That's it. That's all I want to do. Okay. And I'll show you inside the stove here. Real quick, like this. Yeah, I guess you're not going to see too much in there, but you can probably see a little bit. You don't really want to see fire coming through there because that means that you're seeing that there's air openings. That will start all by itself. You don't want to see the fire down the bottom there. If you've got fire coming up through, it's going to take longer to start. So, yeah, you don't want to do that because that's why we left the ashes around the side. Because it's forcing the heat and the fire to breathe through that coal stack. Well, that's the thing. Okay, I'll bring you back in a couple minutes when this is lit. Okay, guys, so like 10, not even 15 minutes has gone by. I went upstairs and got 7-Up and washed my hands and come back down. And so now with that fire is going down in here. I'll show you down in here again. And now, when I open this door, look what happens. Okay, now you probably didn't really see that as good as I saw right here, but I now have a fire going on. But if I shut it, you'll see it will go down, but it will light back up. And what's going on is the blue flames are the gaseous, the flammable gaseous that are coming out of the coal now that it's hot. And it's not fully lit, and that's why you're seeing those. So some guys call those the blue ladies, and yeah, well, you're getting a little bit of extra out of it if you can burn that off. So at this point, we just turn off my throttle. Yeah. right? And let that go out. Let that, if you got one of these harbor freight burners there, let that burn out, because I've already replaced the tubing on that once, because their double wall tubing ain't no good. So that's American made fuel line on there. But yeah, shut the bottle off before you shut the valve off. And their plastic, I had to make one of these too, so I swept me up a little handle here. But yeah, take that, throw it on the concrete, you're done with that. Now you can go ahead and shut that door. And then I take, there's my little dead man, my little hood thing, and I just leave that cracked just a slight bit like that, because the fire is now just getting started. And then I shut my door, because I don't got a whole lot of heat going on in there. And now that I got the heat going on, I can just leave this just cracked and go ahead and almost completely close this, because it's not quite lit. And yeah, I just got called to dinner. So yeah, but that is how we get my fire started. And then I'll come back down here when I get done eating and throw a couple more shovels of that in there. And she'll be good to go until tomorrow at 6 o'clock at night. So yeah, that's how it's done. Thanks for watching, you guys. You got any questions, leave the comments, and I'll try to do my best to answer your questions there as far as running one of these stoves, any coal stove, like that. And yeah, hit the bell if you like this video and you want more videos and you want to get them as I put them up. Thanks for watching, you guys. John Rockin' TV1 said that.